And it's true that you know we're better now today than we've ever been before in terms of seeking help, you know, a counselor, somebody that's not that expensive, and more people are more open to that. You don't have to say, oh, you know, I'm getting counseling, and then like you're a bad broken person. No, it's helpful. It's helpful in relationships. You know, you don't have to wait till it's completely broken and you can barely think it's going to ever be salvaged, and do it before then. Just tune-ups. I have many friends who do every year or two, they do a tune-up with their partner, whether it's business or a life partner, to say, let's clean up some of the stuff. We keep on coming back. It's a repeating thing. We don't agree. We argue. The temperature rises. Let's get some help to, you know, understand it better and move it away, because it's not serving us.
Yeah, that's important in business partnerships, marriage, everything. If you, a lot of folks give up on their marriage way too soon. They give up over things that can be easily resolved if you talk about it, right? I mean, there are reasons to divorce that your spouse cheats on you or is a drug addict or whatnot. You know, there. But for a lot of folks, they just give up on their marriage too early because or too easily because it's hard. Marriage is hard. No.
I've known my wife for 45 years. We've been married 43 years, and we get asked that question a bunch. People see us in action. They go, "Wow, what's going on with you two? It's amazing." I say, "Look, you see us now because we're operating well together, and we have a really great relationship. But there are times when we do butt heads. There are times when it's painful. There are times when our communication styles." Are we? We can't hear each other. There's something about, what did you mean by that? I don't know. And then, you know, temperature rises. So we have to keep being committed to each other. We have to keep, you know, all these years later, we keep looking for things that we want to do together, and we give ourselves permission to have friends other than each other. And I have lots of my own friends. She has lots of her own friends, and we have friends in common. It's a variety of things, and there are some really great books. There's some amazing people who've written about marriage and long enduring relationships, where I've read some of these books. One of the things about my book that people say they love is the back of the book. There's 75 books that I've read that really impacted me, and I have a paragraph about each of those books. So that may be enough. You may say, I've read the
Yeah.
paragraph, I get it. But you may say, no, I want to read the whole book now.